Welcome guys to my channel Chemistry Lover. So today I am going to discuss a very important topic regarding your competitive exams like JAM, GATE or other exams. So the topic is Vsepr theory. I will not go deeper into the theory, but rather I will tell you how to solve the problems come in the exam very quickly. So in the question, generally the molecules are given like, let's say XeF4. So you have to tell what is the hybridization of this anion and what is the structure and the geometry of this compound. So there is a very shortcut rule to get this. So you have to first identify what is the valence shell electron number of the central atom. So in this case the central atom is xenon, and if we calculate its valence shell electron number, it comes out to be 8. Okay, so it is a noble gas family atom, and its valence shell electron number is 8. And then you have to calculate the number of atoms, number of monovalent atoms which is connected to the central atom. In this case 4 monovalent fluorine atoms are there, and so 4 fluorine atom each contribute 1, so total is 4. 4 into 1 equal to 4. So our total number of atoms will be 8 plus 4 equal to 12. Okay, now what you have to do is you have to divide this total number. So total you have to divide this total number by 2, so you get 6. Now if 6 is the number, then your structure would be octahedral. Okay, so your structure would be octahedral, and the hybridization would be what we call is sp3d2. Okay, so in this case the central atom xenon is sp3d2 hybridized, and its structure is octahedral. And now if we draw the molecule, we find that so xenon in the octahedral all positions are equal. So we can place 4 fluorine atoms and 2 lone pairs will be here. Why the 2 lone pairs will be in the transfer? Why this is not the structure? Now you have to understand this. This is the Vsepr theory. So Vsepr theory is, full form is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Okay. So if the theory tells that in a molecule the repulsion between lone pair is highest, then lone pair bond pair, and the least is bond pair. Okay, so lone pair is highest, then lone pair bond pair, and finally bond pair. So if we look at these two molecules, if these two lone pairs are placed in the same plane, then the angle between them is only 90 degrees. But if they get actually placed, then the angle is 180 degrees. Okay, and now we know that the lone pair repulsion is maximum, so we should think about only the lone pair repulsion. And if we examine these two structures carefully, that this structure is more favorable than this, because in this case the lone pairs are placed in axial direction opposite to each other, so the repulsion is least here. So this will be the correct structure. Okay, now let us take another example, like XeOF2. What will be the structure? So in this case again the central atom is xenon and it has 8 electrons, and in the rule we said that we have to only count the monovalent atoms present in the molecule. So oxygen is divalent. We don't need to count this. We have to only count the fluorine atoms. So there are two fluorine atoms which will each contribute one electron. So it will give two electrons. So 8 plus 2, 10. Now we divide. If we divide by 10 by 2, then we will get 5. So 5 means PBB, trigonal bipyramidal structure. So what will be the structure? So there are many possibilities. One of the possibility is like this. So fluorine and these two lone pairs are placed there, or it may be like this. Oxygen is there, fluorine and there is a lone pair, there is another lone pair, or maybe like that. Xenon, fluorine, lone pair, oxygen is there and lone pairs are there. So among these structures, other structures are also possible, but we have to find out which structure is most stable. So you may know that in a trigonal bipyramidal geometry, all bonds are not equal. These two axial bonds are slightly longer than this equilateral, they are shorter. Okay, so oxygen is double bond. So obviously the double bond is shorter than single bond, and it should be placed in such a position that the bond is shorter. So this will not be the case, obviously. That is, oxygen cannot be placed in the axial form because it has a short double bond character. So it will be placed in the equatorial position. Now these two equatorial by placing this oxygen atom at the equatorial position, these two structures are possible. Now again, if you think that if we put this two lone pairs in the same plane, then the repulsion between them is greater than if we place these lone pairs in the opposite direction. So this lone pair repulsion here is greater than the lone pair here. Okay, but again you have to, but in this case, this is not the case of octahedral geometry. What was the case in octahedral geometry is, or in the octahedral geometry like XEF6, in that case, if we place the lone pair 2, this bond angle is 90 degrees, but in this case the bond angle is actually 120 degrees, so the repulsion is here much lesser. Okay, in addition to this, the fluorine is more electronegative, and according to Bent's rule, the more electronegative groups are placed in the axial position. So what is the basis of this Bent's rule is that a bond which has more S character is likely to occupy atom which bound strongly or less electronegative atom, and a bond which is more of P or D character, that will be bounded to the atom which is less electronegative or like lone pairs. So in this case, this bond has less S character and more P and D character. Okay, so it will bound to this more electronegative fluorine atoms, and this equatorial positions are occupied by the lone pairs. Also, this can be explained by steric terms also. If we place these lone pairs here, what will happen is that it has a 90 degree interaction with these all three atoms. Okay, but if it is placed here, it has only a 90 degree interaction, only one 90 degree interaction. Okay, so So it is 90 degree with respect to only fluorine atom, and this also 90 degree with respect to only fluorine atom. But in this case, it is in 90 degree position with respect to all the three atoms. So the position of lone pair is more stable in this case. So this will be the
correct structure.
Okay. So what we find that this X is F4 is actually structured like this, so lone pair. Okay, and actually this lone pair will push somewhat in the geometry of this molecule will be like this. So this is bent T shape. Okay, so bent T.
This is the structure of the molecule. I will make another video on the Bain's rule where I will clarify the total all the doubts.
Here you should only learn what will be the structure. Let take another example, like what we can do is say H2 molecule. Okay, what will be, we know the structure, but we verify our formula. So if the central atom is oxygen here and it has 6 electrons, and two hydrogen monovalent atom, they have 2 electron each, so we have total 8. Now 8 by 2 is equal to 4. Okay, and 4 means tetrahedral structure, and the central atom is what hybridization is that? sp3 hybridized. Okay, so the structure will be like this, and lone pairs are there. So this is the structure of H2. So now I will give you a complete list of what will be the case. So first, so we take this total electron by 2 as H. Okay, what is the number is H, that is H is the hybridization, we can say. So we will make a list of what will be the case for each H. So here we put H, here we put structure, and here we put hybridization. Okay, so if H is, value of H is 1, okay. So no 1, value of H never will be 1. It will be, if the value of H is 2, then the structure will be linear. The hybridization will be sp. If it is 3, then it will be trigonal. Again, we are talking about a structure, not about geometry. Geometry is determined after placing the lone pair and how it looks like. Structure is the ideal structure. Okay, so trigonal, and hybridization is sp2. If it is 4, then it is tetrahedral, and the hybridization is sp3. If it is 5, then it is trigonal bipyramidal, and hybridization is sp3d. If it is 6, then the structure is octahedral, and hybridization is sp3d2. Okay, and this up to this is fine, because questions came from only this kind of geometry. So by using this simple formula, you can solve much more problems. You should solve questions by yourself regarding this problem. And if you have any, I tried many problems and I never get any problem. If you face any problem using this formula, then let me know in the comment section. Hope this video will help you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel and share it with your friends.